Today I'm going to review this TNA T1200R. That is the tuner on top. And guys, this is real high-end. Eh? So this is not, maybe you don't know this brand, but this is a German brand and it is really the top of the high-end. You know, this is not just, if you're gonna Google, because I want to know from which year this tuner was. Well, I still don't know it. I think from 1994, 1995. It's very hard to find stuff about TNA. This is a very exclusive brand in Germany and it is expensive, you know. Here in the Netherlands, a tuner like this, well, I saw prices between 150 and 300 euro on eBay and Hi-Fi Shark. So the minimum price was 150. But in the Netherlands, you should be glad if you get 100 euro. And like I told you many times before, the Netherlands is not that, prices here are much lower than in the rest of the world. Anyway, this is high-end, my friends, and I already placed all the stations, about 30, so probably it have more space. I'm going to show you the backside of this amplifier, this tuner. And, this is very simple, in fact, it is very simple. As you can see, just TNA, nothing special, and there is the RC in remote control in. Not sure how that works, but I don't have that remote control. And the reason why I wanted to determine the building here is because I bought this tuner together with my ohm speakers, my new ohm speakers over there. Today you will hear the sound from this tuner over these ohm speakers. But I also bought it with this set over here. Let me lighten it up a little bit for you, so you have a better view. It's a little bit dirty, didn't clean it yet, but this is how it is looking. And the preamp is something very special, very good preamp. What I read on the internet, this preamp is a nasty preamp, my friends. The power amp is 2 times 80 watts. The value of that power amp, only the power amp, is about 150 euro, and the preamp have a price from 600 to 700 euro. This good is the preamp, and without the cabinets. The cabinets are very, very rare, and my friends. So this was all including the deal, and the thing is, let me place the lamp back so I have some more light on this. Yes, like this, so I have more light on the tuner. The thing is that for me it's important to know which year everything was bought. You know, the woman could not tell me that when I bought this stuff. So I think the guy was a high-end fellow, because also this Marantz CD player SA8003 came from that same guy. So this is what I bought from the guy, the CD player. Well, this is high end. New price was 1700 euro in 2009. This tuner, I don't know nothing about the new price. I looked it up. I cannot find really nothing, no info at all. And my guess is 1994, 1995, because I saw a preamp from 1995, and that is the same line, same 1200. So that was the P1200R. This is the T1200A, as you can see over here. Let me zoom in for you. This is the T1200A, yeah. And the other one was the preamplifier, that is the P1200R, and then you have the AP, that is the integrated amplifier, the AP amplifier preamp 1200R. So And those things are from 1995, so I guess that this tuner is also from the same age. However, when I see how they use two simple LED lights, not really LED, of course. It looks like a 1980 device, but yeah, this is high end, my friends. This is high end stuff. You know, it always, it doesn't matter how it looks often, as long as the inside is good, as the functionality is good, and the building quality is good. And this thing have a very good building quality. It is heavy amp. Often those tuners are lightweighted, but this thing is really a heavy thing. You can feel the quality inside. And well, this guy who bought this tuner only had quality. You know, he imported those 2 ohm speakers from America, and we all know that importing stuff and paying the tax make a product so much more expensive. Same thing he did with that pre and main amplifier, the Crown amps, or the Amkron, but that is the same as Crown. Amkron is the same as Crown. And so this guy, he just spent a lot of money for his audio stuff, and he spent extra to import it. And as you can see, he only bought quality stuff. Only quality stuff, my friends. I just tested this Marantz CD player, and really it is a very good CD player. And but today it is about this tuner. And it's very easy. Without booklet, it was very easy for me to find out how to store those stations, and it is RDS, yes, and this is how it works. This is how it works. So, and this is how it sounds. I will walk through you. The sound is really beautiful, really beautiful. Listen to this.
And he can't tell us.
Julio,
kit of volatile ingredients. Once they travel up our nostrils, these molecules bind to the odor receptors in our noses. And when this happens, the sensory neuron attached to the receptor sends a signal to a part of the brain called the olfactory bulb.
Mr. Blue Sky, en wat rijden we niet expres omdat het
Well, you have the idea, you have the idea, and I'm glad to be the first one, the very first one, on YouTube with this tuner, even though you're my friends. I have the premiere and I almost didn't make a video from it, but I thought, well, why not? It is high end, you know, it is high end and it is a very good tuner. And of course, what you just heard was the cable. So the cable, that's a pretty good quality in the Netherlands. And well, I hope you like this video, don't want to make it too long, you know. I just wanted to find out, I was digging for 2 hours, you know. If somebody knows exactly who have this thing in his house and know exactly from which year that is, he would be welcome in the comments, you know. Even as as this set, you know, if he knows where this, let me show you this, so this amplifier, the Amkron PSL2 or the Crown PSL2, this thing is, I think, the earlier version, the, as you can read it over here, D150A series 2 Amkron. It is the same as Crown, but for me it is very hard to find info, you know, very hard from which year it is. And I want to know from which, normally I don't care, but I want to know from which year to determine if I'm going to keep these speakers, you know. I'm not sure if I'm going to keep these speakers, not yet, you know, it all depends from which year they are. I just want to know, you know, everything from these speakers, and it is hard to find info. This high-end stuff, my friends, kills me. It really kills me to find some info, probably because not many people, it's not a popular stuff. High-end is never popular, and that's why it is hard to find some info. Even from this tuner, I didn't find any info. No, it is an RDS, but if you see, it is a 1994-1995, but it really looks like a 1981-82. I had Akai tuner from 1982, looking much more modern than this one. So that's why I can't understand that this thing was from 1994-1995. But yeah, that's what I could find. Anyway, thanks for watching. Put those thumbs up if you like this video, and don't forget to subscribe on my channel. For now, I say ciao ciao.